My last doctor's appointment was shocking. I went in and the doctor looked at me and said, "So we found something very interesting in your blood test." Now, on the edge of my seat and just anxiously waiting for the next part, I feared the absolute worst. Fortunately, it wasn't the worst. She looked at me and said, "Your blood tests show that your bones are actually still developing," which was shocking to me. I mean, I turned 26 next month, and shouldn't the body be completely finished growing at this point? Apparently, some bodies will still be growing at 25. This doesn't mean I'm gonna grow another 2 inches, but it does mean that apparently my body is still being developed and is still growing. Now, because I overthink everything, this got me thinking. We never actually stop growing, do we? Or at least we shouldn't stop growing, should we? Life seems to be full of progress. Every few years, a new iPhone comes out. We can now talk to our televisions, and everyone has completely forgotten about 8-track tapes. Yes, I am 25. Humanity is consistently growing and progressing. But what about us personally? Now, physically, we will stop growing at some point, right? Otherwise, you know, you'd be seeing tons of people who are like 8 feet tall roaming around. But what about emotionally and mentally and spiritually? Should we ever stop? We don't know everything and none of us are perfect, so we should technically never stop growing, right? Because we can always progress. We can always be better. So we shouldn't stop growing. At the time of recording this, it is New Year's. So New Year's resolutions are the thing. They are the hot thing, and everyone has made New Year's resolutions. And probably by the time you view this video, most everyone has quit on their New Year's resolutions. But the reality is that this is a season to progress and to think about the last year and to think about how we can be better and how we can actually grow. But like I said, most of us quit that. So obviously there's a problem with just growing. Obviously we can't just grow, otherwise we would all do it. So why do we stop trying to get better and trying to grow? Now there are a lot of answers to that question, but I'm only gonna address one, and it's one that I deal with a whole lot. The problem, at least in my life, has been growing pains. Growing hurts. It's hard to do. It is not an easy task. It is not simple, nor is it very fun quite often. I have quit numerous workouts because of the pain of soreness and all the muscle pain and all of that. I have quit many diets because I don't like the taste of foods and I don't like being hungry. And sometimes I am hungry, although if you're doing a diet where you're just hungry all the time, you're probably not doing the right diet. I've also found it very hard to move past certain mental issues because it's just more comfortable and easier to sit in the issues rather than deal with the problems. Growing pains are real. So all of this just leads us to quit. We just quit. We just stop. We stop trying to grow because taking that risk and it failing and it hurting so bad just doesn't seem worth it. But that's kind of actually a problem. Now the problem with stopping is it makes us complacent and ineffective and honestly just doesn't help us at all. We don't end up doing anything with our lives because we never grew past the things that we needed to grow past. We never learned the things we needed to learn, and we never ended up getting better. So we can't move on to better things. I once knew this person named Anonymous, and I asked Anonymous one New Year's Eve, "Do you have any New Year's resolutions?" To which Anonymous replied, "No, the way I see it is if there was something I needed to change, I would change it when I recognize that I need to change and not wait till the new year." Now I understand that, but the problem is if you got to know Anonymous for very long, you would realize that Anonymous didn't really see anything that they needed to change. Therefore, Anonymous lived in a lot of issues and a lot of pain because Anonymous would never change and never grow because they didn't think there was any problem. The last time I saw Anonymous, they were in a very unhealthy state. And it wasn't very good. Why? Because they didn't think they needed to change anything. I knew another friend. Their name is Unknown. Unknown had a similar problem. You see, Unknown thought they knew everything. They thought they had grown enough. They didn't think they had any more growing to do mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually, knowledge-wise. They thought they grew up, all right? And the problem with this is the last time I saw Unknown, they were 3 times older than me with no job and no prospects of a job because they didn't think they needed to grow anymore. The problem with my two friends is they ended up living these lives that were ineffective and really meant nothing to anyone, including themselves, because they had stopped growing. Now, do I think that they wholeheartedly believed they had nowhere left to grow and that they were as good as they were ever gonna get? No, I don't think that. I think they just fell into the same trap that I fall into quite often, and that's growing is uncomfortable, so I just don't really wanna do it. Let's be honest, sometimes it's easier and it's way more comfortable to just not grow and sit in our comfortable world, but is that really the best idea? Think about this. Use your imaginations, if you will. If you had stayed a toddler your entire life and never grown up, would you enjoy your life? Now, at the moment, that may seem like really appealing because, wow, I wouldn't have all of these stresses of adulthood, right? Like, I could just sleep when I wanted to sleep and someone could stick me in front of the TV and bring me food. Like, that would be super nice. But the problem with that is if you never grew up, you'd never be able to do the things that you enjoy today. Think about it. If you never learned how to walk, you wouldn't be able to do anything. You're relying on someone else completely for every aspect of your life. If you never learned how to talk, you couldn't tell the waiter that you don't want applesauce and you don't want all of those nasty things and pureed carrots. You want an 8-ounce sirloin steak. You wouldn't be able to do that because you never grew up. If we didn't grow, if we didn't get better, if we didn't progress, if we didn't live through the growing pains, we would never be able to live the life that we want to live, and we'd never be able to live the life that God called us to live. Maybe you're not one who makes New Year's resolutions, but maybe you should consider it. Even if you don't call it a resolution, maybe you should look back at the last year and find one area of your life that you think you could grow in and that you think you should grow in, and then focus on that. Try and do that. And is it gonna be easy? No, of course not. It's not gonna be easy. It's going to be painful, but nothing good was ever easy. Nothing worth it was ever simple and easy and comfortable. And if you don't know where to start with all of this, well, I made a video. It's right here. You can click on that and that will give you 3 steps to start growing and improving life. Thanks for watching.